Hi, I am James, and this is another episode of Heads Up for Hosers. In this video, we will be discussing national pipe fittings. These fittings include NPT, NPTF, and NPSM. We will go into more detail later about what these stand for. First, we are going to talk about the most basic pipe threads, NPT, commonly referred to as national pipe tapered. NPT threads were originally designed for water piping applications in low pressure situations. NPT creates a seal by a wedging action. It leaves a gap between the root and the crest as seen in this graphic. This gap creates a possible leak path. Because of this wedge design, these fittings were never intended to be a connection that would be taken apart on a regular basis. Each time the connection is put back together, the wedge must be driven deeper to create a seal. Soon, there is no wedge left due to wear. To gain a proper seal in NPT fittings, you need a sealant compound, or PTFE. Polytetra, whatever the heck that is, this is because of the gap created by the lower quality tapered threads. When using a thread tape, you have to make sure to actually go in the direction of the threads with the tape so as not to jam up the thread tape when you're putting it into a female NPT fitting. This lower quality thread, caused by rolling, creates a leak path. Because of this leak path, these fittings have been condemned by most fluid power associations in high pressure or temperature situations. For example, the use of NPT in gasoline engines led to a multitude of problems because the fuel dissolved the pipe sealant and leakage became a real issue. To fix this problem, NPTF was developed. NPTF stands for National Pipe Tapered Fuel, also referred to as a dry seal thread. In all appearances, these two threads are identical, except for the small differences in the thread peaks and the valleys. The connection of an NPTF is of higher quality because the threads are machined and not rolled. This creates a close metal-to-metal seal with no leakage path, as was present in NPT. Just like NPT, the threads are crushed together to make a seal, but the higher quality thread of NPTF creates a full connection and thus no sealant is required. You may be asking now how you would tell the difference between the two fittings. Really, the only way is to notice the quality differences. Because NPT is a rolled thread, it will be of lesser quality than an NPTF, which is milled. Here you can see the quality difference. National pipe thread comes in a wide range of sizes here at Gregg's. We are more accustomed to dealing with -2 to -32. Something to note is that national pipe threads do not come in a -10 size. Now you're probably asking, what is a dash size? Well, a dash size is the determination of sizes for hose, tubes, and fitting measurements. This is measured in 1/16-inch segments. In this video series, we will deal mostly with hose and fittings, but note that for tubing, the dash size calculation is slightly different. Now here come a couple of hose examples. So, when dealing with most types of hose, -4 equals 4 1/16-inch segments, which equals 4/16, or equal to 1/4 inch hose ID. Another example is -32. This is equal to 32 1/16-inch segments, which equals 32/16, or is equal to 2-inch hose ID for most types of hose. Now, to measure pipe threads, you need to have an understanding of nominal pipe size as well. Nominal pipe size are confusing because they are based on an antiquated method of measuring pipe and fittings. Long ago, when pipes started being made, they were measured from their inside diameter. So a 1-inch pipe measured 1 inch on the inside and 1.32 inches on the outside. When different applications called for higher pressures, they could not change the external dimensions of the thread. because the pipe had to work in all the same situations. Instead, they opted to make the inside diameter smaller. This means that in this day and age, a 1-inch NPT fitting may not measure 1 inch anywhere on the fitting. But it's a mouthful to call a 1-inch fitting a 1.32 or a 1 5/16 inch fitting. So instead, we opt for its nominal size or in name only for simplicity. So getting back to it, to measure NPT or NPTF threads, you follow the same steps. With a male thread, start by measuring the OD or outside diameter of the third thread. Here we see it is 1 5/16. The next step for measuring national pipe threads is to subtract 1/4 inch from your OD measurement to get to your closest nominal pipe size. For example, the male fitting we measured had an OD of 1 5/16. Looking in our identification book, we can see that 1 5/16 minus 1/4 comes close to 1 inch, which is the nominal pipe size for this fitting. Based on this, we see that this is a -16 fitting. To verify this, we need to confirm the nominal thread size. Here it says 1 inch -11.5, where the -11.5 means threads per inch. We will take out our thread pitch gauge and find the 11.5. Next, we will take the thread pitch gauge and we will lay it on the fitting to confirm that we indeed do have 11.5 threads per inch. This means that this is a -16 NPTF fitting. A female NPTF fitting will be measured close to the same way as the male fitting, but it differs in one way: where you take your initial measurement from. The female fitting ID, or inside diameter, is measured from the largest thread, which is actually located at the end of the fitting. After collecting this measurement, the steps to determine the dash size of the fitting are the same as its male counterpart. To start, you would determine the ID or inside diameter of your fitting. Here we get 1 1/4 inch. Consult your book with your measurement and subtract 1/4 inch to come close to the nominal thread size. Here we see again that for this female fitting, the nominal thread size is 1 inch -11.5. So using our thread pitch gauge, we can put the -11.5 gauge next to the threads to confirm that it is in fact a -16 fitting. NPT and NPTF fittings install slightly different. To install an NPT fitting, you must first use pipe dope or thread tape. Once hand tightened, to ensure a leak-proof seal, 3 full turns are required. Mark your male and your female and then tighten away. To install an NPTF fitting, you do not need pipe dope or thread tape because the well-milled threads produce a leak-proof seal on their own. Instead, you should just lightly lubricate the threads with the oil that will be in your system. Once you have it in hand tight, you only need 1.5 complete turns to ensure it is fully tightened. Any more and you will reduce the life of the fitting. Although NPTF corrected the shortcomings of NPT, it is not without its own problems. Because of the wedging action, it is difficult to orientate the elbows, being that you have to tighten the fitting to a certain spec, and once completed, the fitting might not be orientated to where you need it to be. Also, because of its wedge design, this seal was never intended to be a connection that would be taken apart on a regular basis. Each time the connection is put back together, the wedge must be driven deeper to create a seal, and soon there is no wedge due to wear. Here at Gregg's, we recommend you do not reuse these fittings. These are a couple of the reasons why the industry has moved away from NPT and NPTF fittings. A common problem when identifying NPTF fittings is their relationship to BSPT or British Standard Pipe tapered threads. Although we have not touched on these fittings that much yet, it is important to know their relationship when attempting to identify NPTF fittings. Because BSPT fittings share a lot of the same design characteristics to NPTF, they can often be mistaken for each other and, at certain sizes, even thread together fairly well. Referring to these size charts, we can see that when dealing with -8 or -12 fittings, these two share the same nominal pipe size and thread pitch, making identifying them very difficult. Truthfully, the biggest difference is that pipe thread has a 60-degree angle thread angle, whereas BSPT has a 55 degree thread angle. This means that even though they feel like they thread together well, the difference in thread angle means that a true seal is never formed and there's a chance of leaking. Because there is no discernible difference between these fittings, it is recommended that you question what equipment this fitting came off of. Depending on the type of equipment and the country of origin of said equipment, you can have a sense for what type of fitting you are working with. For example, if the equipment is from a European manufacturer, your fittings will most likely be a BSPT rather than NPTF. This is a rare circumstance that you will get to this point, but for a -8 or a -12 NPTF fitting, it is important to note that this mix-up could be a possibility. To solve these shortcomings such as orientation, on the next episode of Heads Up for Hosers, we will discuss the NPSM thread. On behalf of our employee investors, thank you for watching this video, and we'll see you on the next episode of Heads Up for Hosers.